How can I turn around my situation in spite of being from a small town? And when you do that mental cleaning, na, life turns around. You know, the most successful people in any profession are not those ones who are the most intelligent ones.
Do you belong to a small town? Are you struggling to make it big in a big city? Do you want to learn principles to get to the next level? Well, you are at the right place. Welcome to the podcast, Small Town, Bigger Dreams, where I help you with some principles, guest interviews, and stories to help you make it big.
Good morning, afternoon, evening, people watching this or listening to this podcast, Small Town, Bigger Dreams. As I said earlier, we are going to have some exciting episodes, not only the monologues. So presenting to you the first flavor of that. And today I've got a guest, a person, someone who always inspires me every time I talk to her, someone who's a great motivator, passionpreneur, as she calls herself, and is also an author of a new book called Unleash Your Spark. Let's put your hands together for Taiba Mehboob. Welcome, Taiba. Welcome to this podcast, Small Town, Bigger Dreams.
Thank you so much, Haritosh. It's my honor to be coming on the show of my mentor. So I think I'm really happy to do this.
Awesome. I called you because I get really inspired by your journey, specifically the way you take things and you execute things in such a short time with great perfection. So I am really impressed by that. So you're my favorite.
Thank you.
Let's talk a little bit about your journey. So for our viewers and listeners, would you tell a bit about your journey?
Sure. So my journey starts when I got rejected from the college of my dreams. And that is when the whole unleash the spark moment started within me. And that is how it reached full-fledged, spark. That, you know, I wanted to do something. I wanted to find what is it that, you know, brings butterflies in my stomach. What is it that, you know, makes me happiest as a person, as a professional. So I started looking for answers. And, you know, as they say that, you know, when you seek answers, universe gives those answers. So I just kept following things. I had a plan of writing this book, but it was very vague. So I just made this plan concrete, and I signed up for a writing class, and I started working on my passion also side by side, exploring things. And I realized I love coaching people. That's my passion. That's my intrinsic motivation. So this book is all about that only, finding your passion.
Awesome. We're going to talk about your book a little bit more. But let's talk a little bit more about the mindset thing. This podcast is specifically for people from small towns, as I say, as the name suggests, Small Town, Bigger Dreams. And there is a great deal about mindset and things that stop people from taking the action, and especially people from small towns. So what do you think are the reasons for that, and how do they can overcome that?
That's a great question, Haritosh. I can totally relate, because few years back, I was also kind of in this mindset that, you know, hey, I'm just from a small town place. I belong from Uttarakhand in Haldwani. That's a very, small, sweet place. There are mountains just around my place. So I was very ambitious kind of girl. I knew that, you know, I have so much fire in my belly that things will come in my life. I will go to places, but I had those vulnerabilities and insecurities about myself. Will I be able to do it? Do I have that potential or not? And, you know, all those mind freaks I call, you know, which are your internal voices questioning you every now and then. So I had all those questions. Am I good enough? Do I have the right talent? So I had all those questions, but I slowly started, you know, asking the right questions. Asking the right questions, you get you get the right answers. If you ask questions like, how can I make my life beautiful, or how can I make it big in life if I just belong from this place? So the mind will say, yes, you belong from this place, so you can never make it. But how, if you ask the right question, how can I turn around my situation in spite of being from a small town? Now that's a game changer. Because, you know, that gives you that answers that how can I reach to those people who have already made it big? They were also from small places. They were also from small towns. But they, you know, had their beautiful journey of climbing up their ladder of success. So asking the right questions is, you know, it will really help you challenge your beliefs, because it is all about beliefs. What you believe, you envision, you actually achieve it. If you can believe it, you can achieve it. And if, there's nothing right or wrong about beliefs. Like if you think that you can, then obviously your mind will start going in that direction. And if you think you cannot, then it is also like, you know, there's nothing right or wrong. You will go in that direction. So I think these are two different directions.
All right. So that's a great answer. So if you think you can, that's a great quote. If you think you can, and if you think you can't, in both ways, you are right. So great answer by you. My next question to you is, what, I know you are an avid reader. You read a lot of books. And I know one of the things I really recommend to anyone is reading different kinds of books. So what's your top 2 to 3 books that you have read recently and that have been totally transformative for you?
Okay. So this question is very close to my heart. Currently, I'm reading a book by Lucy Hay. It is Heal Your Life. So this book talks about how we have so many inner voices, internal limiting voices within our heads. And that keeps happening on a day-to-day basis. Mm-hmm. Like, it's a process. So to change the process, you need to, she calls something, you know, mental cleaning, just as you do the cleaning of your house. She calls that, you know, all these limiting voices and these mind freaks, they will keep coming. So you have to, you know, actually observe them. And there is a process through which you can do the mental cleaning. And when you do that mental cleaning, life turns around. So that's a beautiful book. And she tells that how people, you know, develop psychosomatic diseases because of their, you know, internal voices that they keep on hearing within themselves. You know, thoughts of guilt, thoughts of, you know, regrets, thoughts of, you know, incompetence, thoughts of not being able to cherish themselves as they are, not being able to accept them for who they are. So when I started reading this book, my perception towards my own self, towards my own abilities, totally changed. Even if sometimes I screw up, I don't criticize myself as harshly as I used to. Because I think we are all being too harsh on ourselves in this modern era where everybody is competing to get the top spot in the rat race of life. We have all forgot to cherish our beautiful selves that, you know, God gave us. And it's a really high to first cherish yourself, because if you can treat yourself right, you can treat everything else in the right way. So that's my top book right now. And then the next book that I'm also reading is Unleash Your Power. So it is again by Tony Robbins. It talks about how, again, your beliefs are the core of your life and how success is 80% psychology and only 20% skills. So again, if you see, it is all a game of your psychology. He says that, you know, great entrepreneurs, the difference that makes the difference is psychology. The difference that makes the difference is psychology. So if you can really learn how to master your mindset, how to master your thoughts, your emotions, then is the time that you have actually mastered life. Because then if you know how to master your inner self, you know how to master everything else. You understand people on a better level. And the third book that I read was again, Awaken the Inner Giant. That is again by Tony Robbins. So Tony Robbins is my all time favorite author. But yeah, this book, Heal Yourself. heal yourself is again very beautiful, and it has given me a new perspective to life and, you know, treating my own self in a different way.
Awesome. I loved your answer, and Papa, love things like cherishing yourself. Yeah, and I know many of us are really, really harsh on ourselves. We take ourselves too seriously, and we don't cherish the current present moment. So a great observation on that. And then mastering your inner self. Yeah, Tony Robbins, we all know, is the number one trainer, number one motivator, and so many things. So we don't have enough words to describe him. So great, great choice of books, I must say. Let's talk about your book. So what's the journey of your book, and what if you want to give us a summary or gist of your book, Unleash Your Spark, what would that be?
Okay, so my book is all about passionpreneurship. Now, what is passionpreneurship? Passionpreneurship is taking your passion, finding it, and converting it into a venture, profession, side hustle, whatever is suitable for you. But I believe personally, it's very, very important to discover your passion, because, you know, as T. Harv Eker said that, you know, people will always tell you what you should do. You know, even if you're at the age of 50, even if you're 60, 70, whatever your age is, whatever that number is, people will always tell you what you should do. And they will go. They will leave.
Right.
So after that, the baggage of that path that you have chosen would be upon you. Mm-hmm. So you should take the onus of responsibility. Many of us, we are very scared to take that onus of responsibility. What will happen if I lose that job? But think of the bigger picture. What kind of impact will you leave if you chose this path, if you chose the road not taken? So think of the prospects. I'm not saying that quit your job immediately. I'm saying make informed decisions. But it's very, very important to, you know, unleash your inner spark, to do justice to that. So the first few chapters I've written, why passion matters and how can you find your passion and all those things. And Robert Greene, I've also written that, you know, the most successful people in any profession are not those ones who are the most intelligent ones. The most successful people in any professions are the ones who have a very deep inner emotional desire to serve people through their passion. To, you know, that has much more to do with our emotional self rather than just our logical self. Often when we think of success, we always think it is just about, you know, it is just about rational thinking. It is just about logic. It's just about our abilities. But we are wrong. It is not just about our abilities, about, you know, our rational thinking or the logics that we give. Because our heart, our mind takes decisions based on emotions, not on logics. We think we are very logical. But logics, you know, emotions will come first and they will be backing the logics. So it works the other way. So I tell, so then I talk about mindset. Because, you know, if you want to pursue something, I can tell you the most amazing skills that, you know, you can learn and do amazing things in your life. But if you don't have that state, if you don't have that mindset, then you will never take that path. So the first important thing is mindset. So I talk about mindset, why it matters. Then what are limiting beliefs? They're just like chains, always holding you back. And then I talk about, you know, strategies. You know, how can you break these chains? How can you eliminate your limiting beliefs in very practical ways? There is a disempowering belief that you have been holding yourself with. And now there's an empowering alternative that you can choose to follow. Okay.
Awesome.
And then the other day we were talking about this thing that, you know, we all have beliefs that, you know, and our beliefs are just like, some beliefs are so disempowering, they are like dysfunctional apps. What happens to a dysfunctional app? We just uninstall them. But why not with our beliefs? So I give you that, you know, how do you uninstall your inner disempowering beliefs? And then I talk about the whole strategy. If you want to be a digital coach, how can you pursue that whole journey, finding your niche, pitching yourself in the market, marketing yourself, making yourself a personal brand and doing sales. And then I also tell that this is a long journey. It's a marathon, not a sprint. So it's not a quick fix to success. You have to be patient and you have to be willing to put in that kind of hard work into it.
Amazing, amazing, Taiba. I can feel that you have put a lot of passion into it. You have put a lot of hard work, and I'm pretty sure it's coming out beautifully. As soon as it comes out, I would be purchasing my copy of the book. I'm really looking forward to it, and I'll be posting the link of, I think the Kindle version is already out.
Kindle version is available. The
link of the Kindle version will be in the description of the YouTube video or also in the podcast. And this is going to be my last question, because I know we all have limited time. So if you have to give a couple of advice to any young students, entrepreneurs, or anyone, and especially from small town, what would that be?
I would say that be fearless to follow your dreams. I know it takes a lot of courage. I know you would be different. You would be the odd one out. But you know, 10 years, 20 years down the line, you would be somebody who would have who would just not be a person. You would be a personality a few years down the line. So if you can see the bigger picture, if you can dream it, you can achieve it. So just be focused on that journey, enjoy that journey, and just have faith that you can, and put in consistent action. Just make plans, but execute them. Just don't write them on papers. Just execute them for real. So like my next, I'm now taking a coaching again to become a digital coach. So for that, I'm taking coaching from Siddharth Rajshekar. He's a very big digital entrepreneur. So I want to start my digital academy very soon. So that's another ambitious project that I plan to execute within 3 to 4 months. And yeah, so have faith within yourself. Just don't write plans on your paper. Execute them for real, and be badly persistent. One of my interviewers, I interviewed him, and he said that it's not about actions that are executed sometimes. It's about persistent actions. So as Tony Robbins also said, that take persistent, massive action. So yeah, do that. And you would just see that, the things that you were imagining, they will start happening for real. So just have faith and keep doing the things that you love doing.
Awesome. So have faith and keep taking massive action consistently and persistently. Thank you so much, Taiba. This was a really short notice, and really appreciate you taking time out of your schedule and helping with this podcast. So thank you so much, and wishing you all the best for your book. And I'm really looking forward to have a copy for myself.
Thank you so much, Haritosh. It is my honor to be here with you, because as a person, I admire you very much. And that happens for a reason, because you say, you walk the talk, and you actually execute what you say. So that has always built that kind of trust. And I'm sure your book is also going to rock when it comes out. I'm also waiting for it. All the best.
Thank you so much, Taiba. So that was Taiba Mehmood on the episode of Small Town Bigger Dreams. And as I promised, there would be a next episode in 2 weeks. Until then, keep learning, keep growing, and keep going out of your comfort zone. This is Haritosh, and I'll be back with another episode of Small Town Bigger Dreams.